we can travel back in time by looking far away. This simple yet astounding fact enables astronomers to observe snapshots of the universe at various times, which they can then use to piece together the complex history of cosmic evolution. We can see further and earlier into the history of the universe with each new telescope we build. The James Webb Space Telescope aims to look back in time to when galaxies first formed. Hey viewers, welcome back to the Future Space. In today's video, we are going to discover galaxies that have never been discovered. So stay with us till the end of this video so you don't miss out on any of this information. But before we proceed, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and click on the bell symbol so that you don't miss out on any of our wonderful videos in the future. And let's get started. Looking out corresponds to looking back is a relatively new concept. It derives from Einstein's special relativity theory, which states, among other things, that light travels at the speed of light and that nothing travels faster. We almost never see the consequences of this concept on a daily basis, because the speed of light is so great, 300,000 kilometers per second, that this travel time hardly matters. When we turn on a light or receive an email from Europe, seeing the light bulb turn on or receiving the email is instantaneous because light travels through a room or even around the entire Earth in a fraction of a second. However, the finiteness of the speed of light has profound implications on an astronomical scale. The Sun is approximately 150 million kilometers away, which means that sunlight takes approximately 8 minutes and 20 seconds to reach us. When we look at the Sun, we see an 8-minute-old photograph. Andromeda, our nearest neighboring galaxy, is about 2.5 million light-years away. When we look at Andromeda, we see it as it was 2.5 million years ago. This may seem like a long time on human timescales, but in terms of galaxies, it's a very short time. Our stale image is probably still a good representation of how Andromeda looks today. However, because of the vastness of the universe, light travel time is important in many cases. When we look at a galaxy from 1 billion light-years away, we see it as if it was 1 billion years ago, which is enough time for a galaxy to change dramatically. Never before have we been able to view the universe in the manner in which it is currently being shown to us by the JWST. When traveling through light and space, James Webb is able to see the origins of the universe, which is something that our minds can only begin to scratch the surface of comprehending. The human eye would never be able to see what the telescope sees. The first images that were shared by this powerful telescope on July 12 showed us distant galaxies, the end of stars' lives, and the atmospheres of planets that are not in our solar system. These images work like a time machine to show us these things. The so-called phantom galaxy is depicted in one of the most breathtaking images that have been made public to date, M74. Because Webb is able to pick up longer wavelengths of light, scientists are now able to pinpoint regions in galaxies such as this one that is active in star formation. The image shows a dense cluster of stars at the center of the galaxy, as well as vast amounts of gas and dust in the galaxy's arms. Jupiter and all of its moons presented to you in a way that you have never seen them before. NASA researchers have also shared fresh imagery of Jupiter, which they describe as quite incredible. Jupiter is the largest planet in our solar system. The photographs were taken in July by the James Webb Telescope, which captured views of Jupiter's northern and southern lights, as well as its swirling polar haze that had never been seen before. The Great Red Spot, a storm on Jupiter that is so large that it could engulf Earth, stands out prominently among countless other storms of varying sizes. One of the wide-field images is particularly captivating because it reveals the barely discernible rings that are located around the planet, in addition to two minuscule moons set against a glittering background of galaxies. We've never seen Jupiter like this. It's all pretty incredible, isn't it? Planetary astronomer M.K. de Pater from the University of California, Berkeley, who helped lead the observations, was quoted as saying this. He continued by saying in the statement, "To be completely honest, we hadn't really expected it to be this good." According to the research team from the US and France, the infrared images were digitally colored in blue, white, green, yellow, and orange so that the features would be more noticeable. Additional findings include the ways in which the cartwheel galaxy is undergoing change. The most recent images were taken just a few weeks after another batch of images captured by the James Webb team showed us the cartwheel galaxy in more depth. These images brought us one step closer to comprehending the universe by demonstrating what occurs when two galaxies collide. With the help of its infrared cameras, the telescope was able to peer through the cosmic dust that was produced by the collision and give us a glimpse of how the Cartwheel Galaxy is changing as a result of its collision with another, smaller galaxy billions of years in the past. The Cartwheel Galaxy is a ringed galaxy that is over 500 million light-years away from our planet. It gets its name from its bright inner ring and colorful outer ring, and scientists believe that it was once a part of a large spiral galaxy like the Milky Way, but that another galaxy smashed through it at some point in the past. According to NASA, the high-velocity collision is responsible for the entire appearance of the galaxy, which at the time reminded researchers of the wheel of a wagon. The galaxy's two rings have been expanding outwards from the center of the collision, which has resulted in the creation of a rare ringed shape. Never before have scientists been able to make sense of the disorder that exists within the Cartwheel Galaxy and see clearly into its depths. The Hubble Space Telescope has already taken a peek inside the galaxy, but due to a large amount of dust that surrounded the Cartwheel Galaxy, the telescope was unable to observe the phenomena that were occurring inside the galaxy itself. However, now that infrared cameras have been installed on the JWST, scientists are able to look into the bright center of the galaxy. In order to accomplish this goal, an image is produced by combining Webb's near-infrared camera and mid-infrared instrument. These two instruments are able to see through the dust and reveal wavelengths of light that cannot be observed in conditions where visible light is present. The image that was obtained demonstrates the process of star formation that occurs after two galaxies collide. This is a phenomenon that is not yet fully understood by scientists. According to NASA, the bright core at the center of the galaxy is made up of hot dust, and the brightest areas are home to enormous star clusters that are still relatively young. The birth of new stars, on the other hand, is something that can be observed on the ring that is even further out. Even though it may take billions of years, the Cartwheel Galaxy is still undergoing transformations and will continue to change in the future. These changes promise to reveal more secrets about how galaxies evolve over the course of time. The successor to the Hubble Space Telescope, which cost $10 billion and was developed by NASA and the European Space Agency, was launched at the end of the previous year and has been conducting infrared observations of the cosmos since the summer. With the help of the JWST, researchers are hoping to get a glimpse of the universe as it was 13.7 billion years ago, when the first stars and galaxies were just beginning to form. The distance between the observatory and Earth is approximately 1.6 million kilometers. And that's it for today, guys. We sincerely hope you enjoyed the video. If so, please click on the like button and share it with your family and friends. If you have any questions or comments, please share them with us in the comment space below. Also, don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel to see even more of our incredible videos. You can also check out our other videos that have been specially selected for you. We'll catch up in the next video.